Hey guys, welcome back to the channel, man. I got a lot to cover with you today. This is our Coffee with Conti. It's gonna be that, you know, a little longer chilled out vlog. Just imagine me holding a coffee cup right here. They're ordered, it's not here yet. I'm relentless though. I went to the CVS pharmacy over here. Look at this that I got you guys. Look at that, is that cool? $10. Look at this one. $10 at CVS pharmacy. That's pretty cool. I don't really have room for any of this stuff, but I just keep buying. The ones that I don't have, I keep buying. Also today on the vlog, I got a couple of cars I want to load, and then we're going to go hang out with Chuck, and then we're going to announce the winner of the Corvette Special Editions book. But before we get really rolling with today's vlog, I mean, we kind of are right now. Wow, you guys. The responsiveness from our last vlog, that was my military vlog that tied into Veterans Day, and I don't even know where to begin. All of your comments were very touching to me. Some of you that watch our channel never comment. That video motivated you to make a comment. And I got a couple emails here that I want to share with you on that. And I'm just so glad that I can be me on this channel and share that with you and share other great things that intertwine, yes, with Corvette. But just really good people and really good things. This platform is pretty powerful. I take it serious, and I do appreciate that. Just give me a second to read this with you guys, and let's get going. I got a couple cars to load. Jason in Washington, Chris in California. Yeah, man, your cars are coming. But in that military vlog, I'm going to read this one last. Now, this one's from Toby, a past customer of mine in Kansas, and I appreciate him watching. Anytime I get a response from him is just fantastic. Guy's just a great guy. Reading this email though was powerful. Share that with you right now. It says, Rick, wow, just wow. This is definitely your best vlog you've put up so far. What a great story about Doss and Jesse and their trials and tribulations, sticking together and getting the well-deserved reward. I truly believe they deserve more. I'm secure enough to say that I had a couple of tears running down my cheeks as I watched that, and I was hoping that no one would be knocking on my office door to see that. Toby, I'm right there with you. I cried when I was at the event. I cried when I edited the video. I've cried when I read some of the emails and comments you guys have posted on the channel. I'm trying to keep together right now. You guys can get to me again. This story illustrates to me how things should work, and it reminded me of our own son who joined the Army in wartime. He knew this before he enlisted, and he would be deployed, and he did it anyways. He deployed to Iraq and Afghanistan as an Army MP, mostly leading convoys. Coming around a bend, its convoy takes on first fire. He came back whole, although 40% disabled, and is living in suburban Denver with his wife, his dog, two cats, and a Challenger Hellcat. Yes, a Challenger Hellcat. Rick, where did I go wrong? Toby is a true blue Corvette guy. If I had my way, he says, every military member, first responder, and school teacher would get an immediate 100% pay raise. Funny where our priorities lie, huh? Thank you so much for posting this piece of good news. I wish it could reach a larger audience just so we can be reminded that there are good people out there doing good things for others. Again, that's from Toby in Kansas. Thanks again, you guys, for taking the time on this longer, kind of a, you know, unformatted vlog. Me just, and we're going to get back and kind of do the same thing and sit and talk with Chuck here in just a minute after I ship a couple of these cars. This next one is really, really touching. Now, he posted this as a comment on that veterans military vlog, and I just want to make sure it didn't get buried, and I really want to feature it. Wow. This is from Chucktown Corvettes, talking about that last video. Says, Rick, this was simply beautiful. I'm so glad this heroic couple was blessed with a new home. As I sit here weeping, I remember our Air Force veteran son that passed away 2 weeks ago today. He was scheduled to come visit us next month with his new fiance, who was going to drive our 2019 Grand Sport. Since that didn't happen, my wife and I placed his picture on the dashboard and we went for a drive on Veterans Day. As we drove down the street, the song that started playing on the radio was Knocking on Heaven's Door from Bob Dylan. And that wasn't planned. And he goes on and he says, I know that Caleb finally got his ride in the Corvette, and that was his way of letting us know that everything is okay. God bless you, Rick. Thank you for being a part of that young couple's deserved blessing. I'm sure they'll never forget it. And thanks for being a part of our channel and allowing us to share that. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. Tell you guys, wow. All right, let's load some Corvettes. I appreciate you being a part of the channel and helping us grow and able to share whatever we decide to share, but it looks like that we're all on the same page there. I do appreciate that. So after we load these Corvettes coming up that you're about to see, we're gonna go back in service and screw around with Chuck and talk to you a little bit more. Thanks for joining us. Hey, now, don't let the sun fool you. Yes, I'm wearing earmuffs. And yes, I told you guys, when it comes to the cold, I'm a wimp, man. It's 26 degrees. And he had kind of a weird situation. About a week ago, we were getting ready to load Jason's car going to Washington State. And this guy with this open carrier shows up, and I'm looking, I'm like, what? Because I'm here to pick up Corvette. I'm like, not nothing, ain't. I never send Corvettes open carrier, especially going to the state of Washington. So a little bit of delay, another week later. Hey, the enclosed trailer is here now to pick up Jason's car. And Jason, thanks for your patience, your understanding. You got yourself a beautiful red-on-red Grand Sport coming at you. And it looks like, well, let's see, get out of here from the sun glare. Got yourself a beautiful little Ferrari to keep you company to Washington State. That's pretty cool. All right, let's go get the car. All right, Jason, here she is in the sun, looking great, man. Red on red Grand Sport, red calipers, chrome wheels. Now that's a nice looking car. Thanks for your business, man. I appreciate it very much. I know you watch the YouTube channel as well, so that also means a lot to me. So thank you and congratulations. Before he gets all the way up there, I gotta do it with my opposite hand. Send off Pat. Congratulations to Jason. Woo, appreciate it, man. I'm excited for you, man. That's pretty cool. Which, you know, I talked about this a long time ago. I wish that I had the schedule, just hop in that truck, a little travel, and when the truck shows up at the house, out comes your car and me. I'm always thinking, one day, yeah, one day we'll do that. Thanks again, man. Appreciate it. All right, gang, this segment of the vlog, we're back in service. We're back with our Corvette technician, Chuck. He's over there pretending to be busy. No, he is busy. Hey, it's cold and we're busy with Corvette stuff. He's trying to get the rest of the cars prepped. That way I can take those pictures like you saw in that one video when I was editing. Yeah, I love being here 2, 3, 4 o'clock in the morning, editing videos and uploading pictures. All the stuff I get paid for. Now working for free is fine. You know what's funny? Chuck's over like, what are you talking about now? Rick's gonna tell another story. Well, you know about this already. I have clients that, well, not my clients, dealership's clients, that watch the channel, appreciate what we're doing for the community, bought a Corvette. I didn't even know it. Now, 99.9% of the Corvette deals run through myself. How this one got through the system, I don't know. Well, I do know, but I don't want to talk about it on camera. So anyways, I get this email and this text from this guy. He says, hey, we're coming in this weekend and really enjoy what you do on the vlog. I'm like, oh, fantastic. He says, and when she picks up the car, I was wondering if you could, you know, do your congratulations sign and do the balloons like you did in that one vlog. And I'm thinking, oh, I don't even know who this is. And I felt so bad. So I'm doing some research and here's one that got through the cracks and went through the internet, you know, loop-de-loop or what have you. And some guy on the floor sold this used Corvette. But they watch our channel, found out about Corvettes through our store and through my efforts here on YouTube, and bought this car, but yet wanted us to do all this. And I felt so bad because that day I actually had a lot of people coming in. And so I said something to the salesman, I said, hey, you know, they watch the channel, want you to do some of the stuff, they really like that. And of course he did. Guess what he did?
Hard to say.
Nothing. Didn't do anything, man. I felt so bad because those folks found us here on YouTube and wanted, you know, in sales you always talk about the first impression. For me, I like to believe in the lasting impression. You know, we do the send-off pat, share the delivery experiences with you. I'm getting a long way. Anyway, so that didn't happen. I had another client one time, you know, saw me on the channel, and all of a sudden I walked by, and the guy goes, hey, there's Rick. Hey, man, I watch your channel. And he's sitting down at another guy's desk buying a car. So I guess the message is, hey, man,
I don't like working for free. All the YouTube stuff is free. All the pictures I upload, all that stuff is free, man.
Yep.
I guess if you guys are going to do business, I would love to do business with you. I guess if you found out about, you know, the dealership through the channel, myself, that kind of makes sense, doesn't it? Got that off my chest. Chuck's finishing up. This is a I can't wait to get this one down. This is Elkhart Lake. Elkhart Lake Blue, 3LT, yellow stitching, yellow calipers, yellow paddles. This is a sweet car. I know the sweet spot for Grand Sports right now is the 2LT, but this is 3LT. I can't wait to photograph this and share this with you guys. You're just looking for that, you know, something different, that extra special, that extra thought process before. Yeah. You do. And thanks for the consideration. I appreciate it. So anyways, what I'm doing back here is check. Are you going to come over here and join me at any point? I mean, I know you're working.
Mr. Get busy. Get him done.
I know. You get so sick and tired to come back here every day. It's like, how's it going? I still have this many not prepped yet. No. Guy's working his butt off. You know, one thing I wanted to do. You know, I don't know if you saw this yet, and I wanted to do another bit, you know, kind of a little prank, if you will, on the vlog. Always tied into Corvette. You guys remember this picture, right?
Did you ever see that?
Yeah. Okay, you saw that. It's just too cold to do this, and once I do this bit, you'll understand why. And I wanted to show the whole flush. The torque. You guys are having torque converter issues where you're driving, and it's, you know, that shutter. Yeah, they're pretty good, huh? Yeah. Not quite like that. You know what I mean. It is frustrating, though, and it's painfully obvious. And it is on 15 and newer automatic cars that it happens. We actually had a guy says, I got a 7-speed, but I know it's torque converters. Dude, you don't have a torque converter. It's a manual transmission. The guy swore to you, though.
He did.
He goes, oh, I know it. No, he's like, you're reading too much on the internet.
Uh-huh.
Oh, my gosh. But so we did the fluid flush on several cars, and I'd have to say 99% of those actually worked, where it got rid of that shutter. And I wanted to film that for you guys today, but what he's actually going to do today, and we'll just give you little bits and pieces after my ramblings here, you're changing the whole torque converter.
Yep, you got to do the whole torque converter. One thing I will tell you, though, if you're trying to get that to the dealership to get rid of the shutter, if you pull it down in manual mode and run it up through all 8 gears through manual mode, the shutter is gone.
Okay.
To get it into the store.
Okay, so you're driving, so you don't have to have. I didn't know that.
Yeah, so you don't have that feel.
Drive it in paddle shift, and it'll tell you down in the lower right hand corner what gear you're in. So drive it in paddle shift to get to the dealership if you're really. And I know some folks, and I get it. It's a lot of money. Are really, really frustrated when they're driving it, and it's just like, you know, it's like, what the hell? Are you kidding me? That great tip from Chuck. Drive it to the dealership, and you're gonna drop it off for service in paddle shift mode, and that'll at least give you.
It'll,
less headaches,
yeah.
While you get here. And most of the time, like I said, when he does, and I wanted to, you know, it's a big to-do when he even does the fluid flush or what have you.
Oh, yeah.
I wanted to share that with you. At one point we will, but you'll see just how much is it even more involved when he takes the sucker apart and changes out the entire torque converter today.
Oh, yeah.
And this is probably the first one you had to do like that. I think everything else you've done, the fluid flush on, the filter, and everything else has been pretty good.
Maybe one more.
Yeah.
Okay. But for the most part,
As many of you've done, one or two is...
Yeah.
Pretty good odds.
Yep.
All right. Thanks for joining us, guys. Hey, gang. I appreciate the support of the channel. I appreciate all the ideas, too. Remember last time we were, well, not the last time, but one time we were back here in service, and one of you watching the channel said, hey, Rick, why don't you do a video on how to change the oil in a dry sump system? We did that. Great response. Great education. Great content for the channel. I do appreciate that. Just keep the ideas coming. I've got more stuff coming for you guys. One vlog I'm working on. I'm seeing stuff popping up on Facebook that I really don't want to do another vlog, but I guess we're going to have to. If you're a Corvette owner, you're a Corvette lover, it's going to be a vlog of things that make you cry. You remember that one? Oh my gosh. Another one of those are coming up. Also, too, always like your input and participation in the vlogs. If you got a cool garage, how about a picture? Send in those pictures for a future vlog. This will take a little bit of time to work on, get enough from you guys, and we'll throw that up there.
Ooh.
You see your pictures of your Corvettes in your garage or a special garage you have made up for the Corvette. Some of you guys actually have couches and TVs in there. I want to see it all, man. Email me your garage Corvette pictures and we'll share that on a future vlog. You know, you guys do have some good ideas. I appreciate that participation and that input to the channel. Gives us an opportunity to share that together. One idea I had, kind of talked about it briefly when I was in Oklahoma. We're all bummed that Chuck from Corvettes 918 is not on YouTube, and he started something last year that I thought was pretty cool. I mean, there's all kinds of Corvette events, drive-ins, cruise-ins, what have you, but he did just a, you know, a casual meetup. I guess we'd have to determine where, when, and all that kind of stuff, and just kind of cruise and hang out and talk Corvettes for the afternoon. I think I'd like to do that. I really like to do that, so we'll talk more about that. In the future of the channel, I'm throwing all kinds of different things for you guys around. Oh, let me reply to that. Oh, Rick gave me this idea. I got to reply to that. Rick, slow down. Yep, let the fun begin. This is a big job.
Yeah.
This one, yeah. This is not a fluid flush. When you got to take the whole darn thing apart, this is a big project.
Yeah, I'm going to scatter and splatter.
Just scatter and splatter. A little shop talk from Chuck. Yeah. Ah! Ah! You know, you should feel like the guys at the Bowling Green Assembly Plant.
Right.
How they're working and people are gawking as they're trying to work.
Here's another little tidbit of information.
Ah! What's that?
Well, I'll be here in 1 second. Before you take this last lug nut off, y'all might want to hold the wheel here because usually they flop off. Of course, this one didn't. But when they flop like that, and if your gun's still in there, it'll clean out the mark the rim up on the inside where the lug nut was.
Ooh.
We're full of all kinds of good tips today.
Ooh.
You know, it's crazy. You believe it was this time last year that the ZR1 was just being revealed and all that?
Yeah.
That's kind of crazy.
Time keeps on ticking.
Yeah, it does. Can't keep up, man.
No.
I'm getting old too fast. Let me set the camera down on a tripod. I got a quick little ZR1 story for you. And actually, I have a special vlog coming up for ZR1. I mean, a lot of focus is on C8. Man, the ZR1 is still red hot and rolling. Maybe not as fast as a lot of you would like, but that ZR1 is really a special car, and I do want to focus more on that. Some great reviews from different magazines have been out there. I want to hear some of that video of them cruising around the track. And yeah, we're definitely going to talk about ZR1. But like I was just telling Chuck, it was this time last year, not sure the date that this is going to air, but the ZR1 was revealed. And if you remember, I'll put a link down below in the description because it was still to this date, probably one of the vlogs I worked the hardest on to do that spy car video. ZR1 hadn't been out yet, but I knew from some of the intel that it was coming. And I'm like, oh my gosh, I gotta hurry up and get this vlog done. I already ordered the material, so I got it done. We did the drive, you know, the spy car thing, and it was a great response and a lot of fun. And then all of a sudden, here comes the reveal of the ZR1. I think it was about a week after I did the spy car thing. In that timeline, and it kind of got swept under the rug, and not really a whole lot of people, although one person did see it, saw the picture, and it was the only picture in the world that I posted of the LT5 engine cover. But I cropped it out and all this kind of stuff, and you say, ah, bam, here it is. You know, the stuff that's underneath the carbon fiber cover. And I put that on social media. I hear from someone on the team Corvette, and they said, hey, behave yourself. He said, behave yourself on social media. Sorry, I had to edit in there between the, told you, sometimes it's hard to do videos out here. So they email me telling me to behave myself. And I wanted them to know that I knew more information than I was letting on to, and out of respect, I didn't. We've talked about that before as far as our position and things like that we're going to do. So I didn't say that, hey, I knew the car was going to be revealed. I didn't say the car was going to be revealed in Dubai because I knew that. But I emailed them back and I said, hey, are you taking your sandals to the reveal? And I just, you guys are laughing. You're not even laughing at my joke. But anyway, I just wanted them to know, hey, I knew, and I got the email back, I'm not going. So it was kind of funny. So we had an understanding with each other. I understood where they were coming from, and I didn't want to overstep my boundaries. And I'm behaving myself on the C8 stuff, although I've got some people out there creeping around right now. But again, we're going to focus more on ZR1 because I think we should. We need to. And if, and we talked about this in a previous vlog too, if in fact GM announces that they're gonna build 19s through June, I'm gonna have some extra, many extra ZR1 allocations for you folks that are still frustrated they can't get a car. I'm gonna get out of shot and let him go back to work. You know, it's cool. I just feel like when I turn this camera on and I'm telling the stories, or we're back here working with Chuck, I really truly feel like you guys are sitting right here with me in the service department, you know, in my office. I really just feel like I'm talking with you guys. So I do appreciate you taking the time to be interested in the stuff that I'm doing on my day-to-day stuff. I'm glad that I can share it here on the channel.
Separates the transmission from the torque tube.
I don't
You took some extra time strapping it down. You wanted to do that, so when you separate that and it disconnects from that torque tube, you don't want this thing going kerplunky off the side.
No.
I know, I can tell you, you got it on there good. And guys, that's the precaution stuff that Chuck takes that we enjoy sharing. I guarantee you there's a lot of techs out there who couldn't even do what he's doing right now. And he did it without picking up one piece of paper. I mean, he's just been doing it like he built the car. Now she's separated. So the parts you're going to change tomorrow, which we're not going to show all that because it's basically just be a reversal of what you're doing now, but the parts you're going to change tomorrow, the actual torque converter itself, how big is that?
You can see it once I get it down. It actually,
oh, you actually be able to see it
on the front of the transmission.
Okay. Everything all right?
Yeah, just making sure I ain't got nothing hooked up there, which I don't.
Oh, this piece right here.
Yeah. Yep.
Wow.
Yeah, this is very important.
I got the transmission strapped to this blue adapter plate, and then the whole adapter plate strapped to the transmission jack, so nothing can go nowhere. Very, very important.
You ain't kidding, buddy. Wow. So you can't really see what's wrong with it. Everything's probably internal.
No, yeah, it's all internal. You got clutches inside here, and they say that's what's happening. The clutches are going bad in there, which is giving you the shutter.
Yeah.
So new converter, new clutches, good to go.
Chuck, once again, thanks for letting us hang out with you for the afternoon.
Hey, man.
Appreciate it, man. Yeah, all the folks love watching your work, man. It just takes me out of business a little bit, but I love being back here. I always learn a little something, too, and it's just the stuff that I want people to come to my channel. You know, it's not about just selling a car.
Sure.
You know, this is, you know.
We do the whole game, and then you're just selling. You got to service that bad boy.
This is not glamorous back here, but I mean, this is stuff that goes on, so you know, but it lets you take great pride in it.
Oh, absolutely.
And I love sharing it, man.
Yep.
Nice job, dude.
Thanks. You guys have a good evening.
All right, guys, getting ready to close this vlog. Yeah, everybody's gone. I don't know if I should go with, yeah. No, okay, no camera light. I can give it a chance to adjust. All right, good. Always looking at different things. Yeah, there's my mess of a backdrop. I hope you enjoyed today's upload, but more importantly, our other upload just a few days ago. I hope you guys enjoyed that, sharing the wounded warrior and his wife and his dog, getting that brand new house from all these different people in the community that came together. Oh, man. Words can't even describe how powerful that was. Then I shared with you from one of our viewers that awesome email, also a veteran, and then we were able to share some of those great military Corvettes. But today was just something different, just kind of hang out with Chuck while he's working and talk to you about different things going on that I talk about in the channel. But I did forget to share with you on the channel the winner of the great Corvette Special Editions book. And don't forget, you can buy that. The autographed copy is available at CorvetteSpecialEditions.com. And then if you just want to buy the book, you can buy that via Amazon. I got both those links down below in the description. All right, so I did the elementary thing, guessing a number 1 to 2018. I don't want to make it too much of a brain damage for you guys. I just really was trying to keep it simplistic. But here's some of the numbers that I was thinking about. I kept it fair because I really truly went with the number that first came into my head. So I don't know if you, the lights are kind of low here. Can you guys see that? Okay, yeah, I was thinking of 1965. Some of you, oh, I guess that. I was thinking 1967, I was thinking 2003. I was thinking the number 22, number 65, 16, 2018. Of course, 1953. I think the most creative guesses were done by Jim and a guy, if you can see his name right here, P-I-K-E-G-I. They said 1909, which as much talk as we've had about Zora lately, I wasn't even thinking that, but said 1909 for his birthday. It was really cool, but I thought that was creative and at least wanted to acknowledge it. So we had 23 people at the time of recording this video actually guessed the right answer, and I was guessing 1998. That was just the number that came into my head, so that's what I went with. And the winner of that is Thomas Meredith. Thomas, congratulations. Thanks for watching the channel. We appreciate your support. I'll get your information and we'll get that book out to you as soon as possible. Okay, the place is closed. I am going to get out of here, but I really just want to thank you again for the support of the channel. You know, I don't need those millions of subscribers, because the tight-knit community we have here, talked about it, it's no joke, man. You guys are engaging. We're interacting with each other. I really enjoy it. Just a really good family here on the channel, and it continues to grow. So thanks a lot for that. Support the channel. Real free. Subscribe. Hit the subscribe button. Hit the bell notification next to it. So when we do new uploads, if you want to see what's going on, you can click that and watch the latest video. And also leave a comment down below if you feel like you want to make a comment on today's upload. I do appreciate that. Looking forward to sharing with you all kinds of stuff on the channel. And it's amazing how antsy the market is for C8 news and this. Hey, we're going to stay busy. Even without C8, we're staying busy. So our very next upload is going to be when I went down to Bowling Green, Kentucky for the museum delivery of Ben from Texas, picking up his Shadow Gray ZR1. Oh, man, this thing. Ugh. See you guys soon. Thanks.